Many people tell us what we need to do to stop being lazy and be productive. But did you know that you can actually leverage your laziness? How can you be lazy yet productive? Today I'm going to share with you three simple steps so that you can do just that. Keep watching. What our situation is, you can always find ways and means to leverage them. Just like our laziness, whether you feel it's good or it's bad for you, there are ways you can leverage them. And today, I want to talk to you about three simple things that you can do to leverage your laziness. And these three are simplify, structure, and shift. Let me tell you more about them. The first one is that you simplify your life. Which means that all the tasks that you have in your hand, you can either delegate, automate, or simply eliminate from your list. You see, you feel lazy when you have a lot of things to do. So why not look at them and see how many from that list you can actually delegate or outsource? There are always experts or people who are maybe more qualified than you to do it, so just simply make them do. If you are unable to delegate or outsource, can you automate them, especially those which are repeated tasks? You need to get creative in order to get lazy, and I'll talk more about this in subsequent videos. And if you are unable to delegate it or automate it, then can you eliminate it? Using Eisenhower box, look at the things that are there in your list and are they even required to be there? That is assuming you have a list in the first place. And if you're too lazy to make the list, then maybe you can look at a task and simply ask yourself, why am I doing this? Or what is the need for me to do this? Based on that, you can take a decision whether you want to do it or not do it. And if you're not doing it, which means it is eliminated from your things to do. Simple enough? The second one is that you use a structure. Do you know that you can be productive even while trying to avoid doing something? There's an old idea called structured procrastination, and this is developed by Robert Benchley way back in 1949. And the thought behind this is that all procrastinators, which is us lazy people, usually put off the things that they have to do. Structured procrastination is making the same trait work back for you. I have an entire video on structured procrastination that is coming up next week, but in a nutshell, this is what you should do. Create a list of 1 to 5 minute tasks and call them as a lazy tasks. Now, what do you do when you're lazy? Scroll through your phone or surf channels on TV? Keep a 5 to 10 minute alarm when you're doing exactly that so that you can first of all stop feeling guilty about it. As soon as the alarm goes out, you pick 1 or 2 tasks from your lazy list and do them. Isn't that a good structure? The third one that I have for you is to make a shift. And by shift, I mean reverse engineer your schedule. There are a few tasks that we do which make us feel good about doing them. Notice what they are and do them regularly. Most of us are so busy to get the job done that we don't take time to figure out what works for us. When you reverse engineer, you're actually making that mind work for you. You're making that shift. So ask yourself these questions. I feel my best doing what? I hate doing what? You can self-assess this when you are feeling lazy. When you pick items that make you feel good, those are the things that you will do consistently. So take your time to self-assess, or else you will just end up grinding day in, day out, wondering why the hell are you doing what you're doing. So there you go. That is what I wanted to share with you. Three things that you can do. You can simplify your life, create a structure, and make a mind shift so that you can leverage your laziness. What do you think about this video or the tips that I shared here today? Let me know in the comment section below, or you may reach out to me in any of the social media platforms that I'm in. My name is Aparna Ramesh K. I am a certified coach. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Subscribe and also hit a bell icon so you're notified every week when I post a new video. I hope you have a wonderful time. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next week. Bye.